Hello friends, in this video what I am going to tell you, first of all I am going to tell you what I am going to tell you before listening to this lecture. You must have to subscribe my channel and must click on the like tab. And one more thing what you have to do, you should write down the comment as well, whether you like the video or not after watching this video. And one more thing, you should follow me on www.nahishazar.blogspot.com. Okay, this is torsion, and what is torsion in strength of material? So we will discuss it here today and how can we do that. So let's have a start. First of all, we have to go through with what? We have to go through with definition. And you can see there is a rod and it is designed on the software Abacus or whatever the software it is used. It is ANSYS. You can see in the picture. So I have taken this picture from the Google. And what is happening over here? You can see there is twisting in the rod. And why is it so? Why it is happened? When you will rotate it, so it will start to twist it. So why is it so, and what is torsion? So let's have a start. Torsion is a complex word for twisting. When you rotate something, so it will get twisted. So when you apply torques, when you are applying torques, for example, you are having a round door knob. So when you will open it, so you will rotate it. So when you will rotate it, so it will get twisted on one on another side of the body, but in opposite rotational directions. Then the structure undergoes a twist called torsion. Torsion is the twisting or wrenching of a body by the exertion of forces tending to turn one end or part about a longitudinal axis, while the other is held fast or turned in the opposite direction. So it's happened. It will rotate clockwise or anti-clockwise. So it is the twisting of a body. So why is it so, and why we are going to study in civil engineering? So why is it so happen? Obviously, earthquake comes. So what will happen, landsliding happens, and there is the sliding occurs under the earth as well. So what will happen? So there will be the torsional effect on the buildings structures. So what will happen? So for that, we have to study torsional effect. What is torsion? And we are moving towards this picture, and you can see this is the building, and you can see first picture is the building. And the second picture is of this one is the building. And when you will see over here, so you can see this is the twisting effect is coming over here, and this is the building. So one is moving towards there, and one portion is moving towards here. So why is it so? Because of torsion. So let me show you with my pointer color, and you can see this direction, and you will see this direction. So this will be the rotation occurs. So this is the building, and twisting will occur when there is the movement on the ground occurs. So what will happen? Then there will be the torsion in the building started to occur. And what are the measures we have to take in? So first of all, for that purpose, we have to study the effect of torsion comes on the building. And what is torsion? That is the basic terminology. We have to know it. So let's now move towards the next slide. And what is this? This is the very good slide, and I have found this picture very much knowledgeable. You can say you can learn a lot from this, and this is the practical example you can see, and you can easily differentiate after looking at this picture. First picture is showing you what I have already told you. When there is a body, so what will happen? What will happen? If you are having any body, and there will be the force inward here, and this is inward here. So what will happen? The body will compress. So this is compression. And if the body elongates, as we have done in the UTM testing machine, I have shown you in my previous lectures. So what will happen? The body is stretched, and then there will be the stretching is occur, elongation occurs. Here is what is happening. It is bending, and we have studied in the beams that there is the support reaction. These are the support reactions here, and there is a force acting over there, and then there is a bending occurs. This is bending. We have studied, and now there is the torsion. Force is here. It is moving like this, and this will twist it like this. So this is the torsion. And now you can see if the force x over here at the corner, and this force is opposite to the direction. This is like this, this one. So what will happen? This is shearing stress. So this is compression and this one is tension. This one is showing bending. This one is torsion. You can see there is the twist is occurring over here, and then there is a shearing stress. So this is all about the bending, compression, tension and torsion and shearing on the any bar or any building. Okay. And you can see these things will come over the buildings as well, or beams as well, on the slabs as well. So moving towards the next slide, and what is this? This boy is very happy because we are going to look out the what? We are going to see the test. I have found this YouTube video is very much clear about the practical exposure of the torsion test. Actually, unfortunately, we are not having this machinery, but we will do experiment on the of the torsion, and we have another apparatus, so that is that you will perform that experiment as well. But in this video, what you will see the experiment and how can the experiment will occur. So I have found this video very interesting, so let's have a look. Let me watch. Okay, and we are moving to the pointer options, and I am going to do arrow options automatic, and then I will click on it, and we are moving. The boy was very happy because he was going to watch the experiment. Okay, let's have a look and how we can see the experiment. Let's have a look. Wait, is it sharing with you or not? So this is the video, and the recording is going on or not, and this is an advertisement. So let's have a look. This man is going to elaborate you how the experiment will occur. So I just want to tell you how this experiment goes on. So I will provide you the link of this video as well with my on my VLE lectures, so it will be more clear to all of you. Now you can see this boy, this lab attendant has taken this specimen, and he will put this specimen over here. And how can he do that? So let's have a look. What is he doing? Okay. He is telling you how can you perform this experiment. Now he is going to attach the bar over here, and it is clearly seen how he is performing this experiment. And let's see what is he doing. He is fixing that rod, and then there will be the torsion tester on this apparatus. This is torsion machine, and you can see he will fix it. And when he will fix it, so what will happen? Let's have a look. He is fixing it, and then he will apply the torsion. And you can see the blue one is the motor. This one is the motor. Now you can see he will fix. When he will fix it, so how he is fixing it. Now he is tightening it, and then it will be done. Now you can see, yeah, it is he is going to do that, and now he is going to switch it on the machinery. And now you can see these are the angles. This is showing you the angle 240 degree, 239 degree. These are the angles. Angle of twist, and I will show you the formula as well. What are the formula? And now you can see this is the machine, and it is digital load, and load will be applied, and the what will happen now? What is happening exactly over here? So you can see the twisting started to occur on this. Now it is rotating. One side is fixed, another by other one is rotating it, and now you can see this band is having torsional effect, and it is rotating, twisting. So now you can see it's a rotational twist in this bar, and now it is how much twisting is occurring over there as the load is increasing, and it is more twisting. Look at it. and you can see the bending is occurring over there, and this will help you to understand what is basically the torsion. And actually I was searching to explore and to tell you what which is the best practical or to of explanation of the torsion effect, but when I saw this video, so I realized that this is the accurate video for you guys to understand the torsional effects. And this exactly happens with the buildings when you when we have the rotation on the base ground floor due to earthquake. So the this type of a torsional rotation will occur. And now you can see this is completely twisted and it is rotating. Look how much force is applied, how much force is required to make this to be twisted. Now you can see how much twisting is occurring. Now you can see, wow, it's looking very nice. So isn't it interesting? You guys must enjoy it after watching this video, because this is a very interesting experiment. Hopefully we will be having this machinery in our lab. So now you can see the twisting is occurred. Now he is trying to put it out, and he will take Allen key to put it out maybe, or he will try himself. Now he is trying to explain this, what is exactly occurring over there. The torsional effect comes over this bed rod. The rod was very twisted, was straight, and now it is get twisted. So now it's done, and we are moving towards the next slide. And this boy is very happy after watching this video. So let's have a look now. Okay, let's see to the next slide and what is happening over here. And now you can see this is the dead run rod here, and when there will be the force upward and here will be the force downward, then it will get rotated. So this rotation will be like this. Let me show you. This one is like this. Okay, and this is D is showing you the moment arm of this force. This force, this is the moment arm. Now you can see if you are having this bar, so what will happen, there will be the torque T, this is T, and this is L, the length of the rod, and you will see this twisting occurring. So this will be theta, this portion will be theta, this is R, this is R radius, and this will be diameter, this is diameter, you can see. Now this is all about that. Now we are moving towards the formula, and what will be the formula? Torsional shearing stress, tau, for a solid or hollow circular shaft. We are not considering the hollow circular shaft, we are just moving towards the solid. Subject to a twisting moment T, the torsional shearing stress tau at a distance P from the center of the shaft is tau equals to Tp upon J, and shear stress maximum equals to Tr over J. And how is it so? So I will tell you the calculations as well in the next video, where J is the polar moment of inertia for the section and R is the outer radius. So for solid circular shaft, polar moment of inertia will be pi by 32 into D is to the power 4. So you must remember that polar moment of inertia for the circular shaft, a solid circular shaft, will be pi by 32 divided into D diameter raised to the power 4. Tau maximum will be equals to 16 into torque divided by pi d cube. D is the diameter. D is capital here, diameter. So I am moving towards the next slide, and this is the angle of twist. What will be the angle of twist? I have already told you where is the theta, and L is the length of the bar. So theta will be equals to torque into length divided by jg. J is the polar moment of inertia, and g will be the modulus of rigidity. So where T is the torque in Newton millimeter. So if you are moving towards the foot pound second, so it will be pounds into inches, pounds inch or pound feet it will be. So you have to convert it if it is required. L is the length of the shaft in the millimeter, or it may be in meter, or it may be in inches, and it may be in feet. G is shear modulus in MPa, megapascal, gigapascal, kilopascal, or in FPS system it will be what, PSI or KSI. J is the polar moment of inertia. Obviously, it is in millimeter power 4. I have already told you in my engineering mechanics that moment of inertia, unit of moment of inertia in inches raised to the power 4 or millimeter raised to the power 4. Capital D and small d are diameter in millimeter and small r is the radius in millimeter. So it's all about that. Obviously, diameter or radius must be in inches if you are dealing with the FPS system. So it's all about this formula and how can we apply it. So I will tell you in my next video. So wait for a while and I will show with you as well. But after watching this video and after clearing the concept of torsion, so must keep it in mind that don't forget to subscribe my channel. And I am left with 170 subscribers and my watch hours are completed. It's more than 4,000 watch hours. So I have crossed the limit of restriction of my watch hours, but only subscribers are left. And it is around 170 subscribers to get 1,000 subscribers. So must subscribe my channel and don't forget it. One more thing, if you like this video, must share with your friends and family. And one more thing, do follow me on www.nahishazad.blogspot.com. And if you are undergraduate students of Sirsa University, so must follow me on Mechanics of Solid. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.